morning.
Cheers.
Calling to order the November 12th, 2015 meeting of the Reuse Committee, a subcommittee of the City of Northampton Public Works Commission. First thing on the agenda is to approve the minutes. Did everyone have a chance to look at the minutes that Susan sent around?
I have a hard copy in case you did not.
Are there any changes? Okay. Motion to accept the minutes as written. And a second?
I second.
All in favor? All right. Done.
Excellent.
Who's doing the bag can update?
I'm doing the bag can update. So, things are moving fast, my friends. We have, as you know, worked with Jody Young, who is a local graphic designer, and she came up with this design that we're all really happy with. And it's neat because when you think about plastic bag waste and challenges, it affects the water. So you've got the blue, it affects the land, and it is not, you know, the earth, the green and the brown is kind of earthy, and then the water. So I'm really pleased with it, and we had 150 of these printed up. They're going to be available at the mayor's office, here at the DPW, in the health department, and hopefully at the Chamber of Commerce. We're working on that. We also, this past week, have been working on the website for informational website. If you guys have a chance to visit it and give me any kind of feedback, how you think it might be more effective for both the resident of Northampton and potential business people. There's a informational kind of flyer about why people are banning, why communities are banning plastic bags or reducing the generation of plastic bags. And there are links to other communities that have some of their websites so people can see that this is something that's going on nationally. And then I also have links to articles, various articles about China banning bags. There's a Scientific American article about bag banning. We know do banning bags make a difference from the Scientific American.
Is that on your website?
It's on the website too. Yep.
On the city website?
On the city website. Yep. So, and then I also put a link to The Majestic Plastic Bag, a mockumentary, which if you have not seen it, I think, is it Jeremy Irons that narrates it? I'm not sure who it is, but it's, you know, the kind of classic British documentary narrator with it's really spectacular. And then there's another really cute one from Maine about bags and why, you know, why we ban bags. So I think there's some good information out there. If you're aware of other information that could be added, let me know. And the next step is to fashion, the mayor's going to be sending out a letter probably this week or early next to all merchants, all people affected, telling them about this poster and the website. And there's going to be a press release that's going to be going out this week. What else am I missing? The next step is to fashion from the information materials that we have a point of sale tent card that merchants can have at their cash register, just kind of telling people about the ban and where to go for more information. Now, the next step, since you guys are such creative minds, the next step could be to promote it through some kind of publicity stunt or something that could get people's attention and potentially the press's attention. And one thing, I was talking to Alicia Ralph, via email, and she has connections, as you know, to the chamber, and she said, well, why don't you do something on Bag Day? Which I thought was amazingly brilliant, because it's a bag ban, and it's a Northampton Institution bag day. And she said, even if you have somebody with a sandwich board with this poster on it, mm-hmm. you know, walking around, or five people, you know, walking around saying, hey, you know, this bag that you received in the newspaper today, or that you're using today, is compostable, and you know,
and reusable.
And reusable.
For those of us who are ignorant about bag days, is this a new idea, or is this something that's already been happening?
No, it's been happening for years.
Oh, 20 years at least.
Is it a Chamber of Commerce?
It started off as a Downtown Business Association, then went to.
Are you talking about the business in November where people get a bag?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes.
For shopping purposes.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Oh, so okay. It's a real big, big sale day, essentially, gotcha. And everyone can get money off. But it's a really great opportunity, I think,
That's great.
For us to potentially, I mean, if you guys are up for it. So that's one opportunity. Another opportunity would be, say, in probably after the holidays, or at least after Christmas, have people at grocery stores, and this we might be able to recruit some high school kids for too. You know how you sometimes go to a store and there's a bell if you get good service? I was brainstorming with somebody, and we said, you know, what the hardest thing is to remember your reusable bags. And you either leave them in the house or you leave them in the car. And so wouldn't it be fun to reward people who bring their reusable bags into the grocery store? And you could either be outside or be inside and have a bell and give them like a Tootsie Pop or something. You know what I mean? I mean, everybody who brings in their reusable bags. So these are just some ideas that have been generated. I wanted to put them out to you guys to see if there was interest in getting involved in helping make this transition with the bag. Another issue that has come up is that people are concerned about people who live on fixed incomes that might not have access to reusable bags. And I know that the bag share helps with that. A link to the bag share is on the website too, by the way.
She knows all about this?
What, the
Does
website?
Does she know all about this?
No, I know.
She needs to know about it.
Absolutely, absolutely. So we can talk to her today or whatever.
Yeah.
So is there a way that we can help either seniors or other people on fixed or limited incomes that might need some help with reused bags?
Well, you know, Cereos has a coat rack thing.
That's the bag share.
That has the bags that anybody can take. And if other stores follow that example, then if someone forgets their bag or they can't afford a bag or whatever, they got one right there. But of course it depends on people bringing them back too. But you know, Cereos has been great that way. They go in there and they often have many, many bags available. Mm-hmm. So if somebody can't afford one, it's not an issue.
Roger.
Well, my first thought was we're going to need better warning, because we can have all the posters in the world, but there's going to be a lot of people who walk into the store on January 1st and say, what's this?
Yeah.
I don't have a bag.
Right.
What do you mean you can't give me a bag?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
So that's first off. So, you know, a campaign for, you know, why wait or something like that. You know, get started now. As far as seniors goes, we could have a donation campaign. You know, the stores could certainly promote selling their reusable bags and put them in a container.
Right.
Rather than the plastic, you know, the single-use bag thing they have now, just have it for reusable bags and bring them to the senior center.
Wait, say that again?
You know, they have the big barrel that you can put the single-use bags in.
Uh-huh.
At some of the stores. We'll have a barrel for reusable bags that the stores can sell or give away if they want.
Yeah.
And then bring those to the senior center so people have easy access to them. Mm-hmm. Bring them to the schools, you know, wherever. Just get them out there so that people actually have them.
Yeah.
You know, before Christmas.
Maybe some woodworkers could make us, no names mentioned, but could make us some bag trees like Cereos has, you know, an attractive something that would hold bags so that people can see them, you know, when they walk in and they're right there.
I believe it's at Leeds, maybe David, you know, the huge ball of plastic bags that was used once to demonstrate something.
Oh, yeah.
If that was set up on the...
It's gone.
It's gone?
Yeah.
Never mind.
Gone to bag heaven.
It's gone to bag heaven, although I put a picture of it on the website. So it lives in our memories. So the three things that I put out there was the store, kudos at the store, bag day, something, and then there was a third one, wasn't there? The promotions?
Promoting it at the toy swap? Promoting it at our events?
So bag day is coming up pretty soon, though.
Bag day is
next Saturday.
Is it next Saturday?
The 21st? Is that the 20th? Or this, oh yeah.
It's the Saturday before, right, the Saturday before Thanksgiving.
So that's like, that's not very much time to get.
No, no, but you, what kinds of things appeal? Are you guys, first of all, are you guys game to do something? And second of all, what?
It's just one day, right?
It's just one day.
Yeah, I'm busy that day.
Okay, unfortunately, I'm not gonna be here that day, but here's a couple ideas. First, one was sort of negative, and I hated to lead with a negative idea, but don't bother the merchants. They're just crazy on that day. So you don't want to go in and say, may I use your store to pass things out?
Yeah.
But it occurred to me that on the third floor of Thorne's Market, Rich Meadowitz always brings donuts to get bag day started, and they're handing out free bags. Mm-hmm. So if we had the little quarter cuts, and we're handing that out. Don't forget, bag day starts, and just had a pile of those to give to that area. And I'd be glad to do it, except I'm not here. But he's there, like he gets there at 8:30, and if we just had a stack of those to go with the free bags, to go with the donuts. Mm-hmm. It's where people come in. A lot of times it's out of town people, but it's also where people have known over the years that they can pick up their bag for bag day. So that's a thought.
Well, I like that thought. And and I think that the sandwich board thing makes a lot of sense. It's really simple. Mm-hmm. We can also, I would be happy to, if people would be willing to wear them, make either a vest or hats with lots of plastic bags stapled on them that kind of makes, it makes people turn around and look at your poster, essentially. And maybe we could find some high school volunteers that would be willing to help us and hand out the quarter sheets and just kind of advertise that.
Mm-hmm.
Does that sound good?
Mm-hmm. Anything.
To do those two things?
Any way that we can get some attention.
Also, there's a community board at the library. There's Paradise Coffees, you know, just where we put up either the poster or the quarter cuts, just to remember that this is starting.
Do we have access to City Hall? You know how, like, the hot chocolate run will hang a banner on the top of City Hall? How come our events aren't promoted on those banners, including bring your own bag?
Yeah.
It just seems like the mayor's into solid waste reduction. It makes sense for the city. You know, it'll cost a few hundred dollars, I think, to make a banner to go up there.
Yeah, that's
but
a great idea.
It's the most visible spot in the whole city.
Yeah.
And we've had these events for years, and the city can do more to support them and raise awareness of them.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the banners do cost quite a bit to create.
Yeah. Well, but for our events, which happen every year, you can amortize that over years.
Mm-hmm. Especially if you can change the date.
Yep. Okay, great. Well, so who might be available to help on the 21st? If I pull things together, is somebody willing to do it, or do I need to recruit people?
I can't commit myself quite yet.
I'll have to look. I'm sorry, I don't have my schedule.
I'm definitely busy on late afternoon, evening, and so that's possible for an hour or something. But
Susan, I think you need a plan for what's going to happen that day, and then we can figure out who can help you out with it.
I just made a plan.
So is the plan having someone in the sandwich board?
The plan is to have two or three people with sandwich boards with this poster on it, and some kind of attention-getting hat or something, handing out quarter sheets.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah, just walking down Main Street.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I'm actually double booked at the moment.
Time frame?
Bag day Saturday.
I would say, you know, after, so I can do the early event, and I'm happy to be one of the people walking around, at least for part of the day. Bag day is busy.
7 a.m., 8 a.m.
I would say 10 to between 10 and 4. Not that somebody would have to do that entire time, but between 10 and 4 and 4 and 5 would be the best.
When did the donuts start?
I think 8:30 or 9.
Yeah.
I would prefer to do earlier, mm-hmm. like an hour for like. Mm-hmm.
When
nine.
Do the stores open?
Yeah, it's when people can show up. In the afternoon. Maybe at the recenter in the morning, but I think I could do it in the afternoon.
Okay. And Mac.
I'll let you know.
Yeah, let's check our schedule.
Okay.
Susan.
Okay.
So I would suggest sending an email today, right after the meeting. And to everybody,
uh-huh.
and then say, okay, I need a commitment by midnight tonight.
Okay.
Can you do it or can't? You know, what hours would
okay.
be best?
How about a poster in the parking garage by the painter?
Yeah, that's a
it?
Great idea.
A poster in the parking garage.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
So you'd have to get the support of the mayor and the parking commission
mm-hmm.
to do that. So. I'm looking at you.
Yeah,
while
I know,
I'm thinking.
But you're thinking, right?
Yeah. And so, isn't this all instigated by a committee that you were on mm-hmm. with the mayor and other people? Mm-hmm. So the idea that here's some ideas. The parking garage is a perfect mm-hmm. place for the posters.
Mm-hmm.
There aren't a lot of posters in the parking garage, so
mm-hmm.
they may have some limitations on that. But the banner, the parking garage,
mm-hmm.
I would also help whatever the process, if you have to go through Ned or that committee
mm-hmm.
and to find out. But the parking garage is where people, you know, are parking the car, getting out,
sure.
and the idea like, do you have your bags with you or something
mm-hmm.
like that?
Mm-hmm.
You have just a city event board,
mm-hmm.
you know, that the city is just set for the city.
Mm-hmm.
Doesn't have to be mm-hmm. anybody else.
How about any gut bags campaign?
Yeah, you got milk bags.
Well, yeah. I think at this point, I think that this will be the, instead of a got bags thing,
mm-hmm.
which
this is the campaign.
This is the
right.
campaign.
Yeah.
So
finding a
so
place.
So this is
right.
like, yeah.
Right.
yeah.
yeah.
So
right.
library, maybe, I don't know, churches or.
BYLB.
What?
BYLB.
Schools, are they going to be posted at school, yeah. Susan?
Anywhere that'll take
because
them,
wherever you have a car queue, people just sitting
mm-hmm.
there,
yeah.
they have time to register
yeah.
what's on the poster.
Yep. Yeah. Yeah.
Bridge Street, Jackson Street.
Well, and if I make a little hat or something, going in the morning with a, you know, walking up and down as parents come will also be helpful.
Ah, boy, if you get some word of mouth, you know, parents, that would be great to get a few people to just say, hey, you got any reusable bags?
Right.
For the bag
yeah.
band, people go, what are you talking about?
Right.
Could the man send out? Is a lot of people on the bus. Could the mayor send out a flyer prior to the bag day event?
It's true. He can
sure
post it. He has a Facebook account.
Yeah,
he can post
Twitter
it on that. We should
right.
post it on ours.
And we should all repost it to all our friends.
Yeah,
right.
Exactly.
Right.
Get it out.
Yeah,
mm-hmm.
absolutely. So the last thing I need to do is make the JPEG and the PDF available online of the poster.
And maybe you can send it to us, and if all of us post it mm-hmm. on whatever social media we're part of,
right.
that'd
be great.
What are the stores doing, and especially the big stores? I'm thinking of Stop and Shop, Big Y.
I don't know.
It'd be nice for them to just, you know, have a little advance warning for their,
mm-hmm.
their
well,
customers.
Well, no, I mean, they know.
They know, but
they
what
know,
are they telling
the,
their customers?
Well, that's what the mayor is.
The little flip thing.
These are available for them, and the mayor is having letters being sent out.
Okay.
I mean, you know, the, we're a small community. We're doing a lot more than most small communities who've banned. I was trolling around looking at websites of various other communities, and most communities have just minutes from the whatever meeting. You know, there's very little online in most small communities. It's just the big communities like Seattle and Portland that usually have stuff. So we're already doing more than some communities.
You can push our brand at the same time with the big R and the big U. Don't forget to reuse your bag.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay, that's it.
All right. I'd like to skip over the America Recycles Day plan for the moment, and put it later in the agenda, because the toy exchange is the real important thing that we're here to talk about today. Mm-hmm. So, recenter update.
Matt? We finished our first season in the recenter successfully.
Yay!
Good safety record. A lot of happy customers.
Is this the rewind?
Right, and now we are officially closed. Although I was out there last weekend working, and people still—it's kind of like what you were saying about the back. People are like, "What? You know, it's closed." You know, or other people come out. What? What is this place? You know, it still goes on. But so we're basically trying to clear the space out as much as possible, because we don't want to winter over a lot of stuff in there that's been in there already. So. You know, we're trying to get stuff out to end users, and also, I think we want to do somewhat of a deep cleaning in there and a reorganization over the winter to improve the utility of the space. So we're focused on that at this point. And also, it's possible, you know, I spoke to the gatekeepers yesterday a little bit about how if they are there, they'll be there over the winter. If we're not there and some good stuff comes in, if we have our space cleared out and there's stuff that needs to be protected from the weather, then they can put it right in there. So we had several of us out, and you know, I think several of us are committed to continuing to go out, and I'm telling people that stop by, hey, you can take anything you want. We're really not taking big stuff now, but if you know, if they have a couple of small things that I think would be useful, then sometimes I've accepted a few things. But so it's been kind of a soft closing, I guess. And the subcommittee has plans to go out there and look at the space and talk about moving things around. Susan's had a conversation with Ned about the roof and the annex, mm-hmm. which has been leaky, and we're really trying to get that taken care of so that that becomes relatively waterproof, so that ultimately we can store things in there like furniture that would otherwise be damaged by water that we can't put in there at this point. So I think that's something that we're, and that space is going to need kind of a significant reorganization too to make it more useful, I think. So, anybody else want to chime in about that?
There's my neighbor's putting up paint. It's an aluminum paint. It's $60 for 5 gallons. I don't know how many he's using. Got barns and stuff. It gets 10 years more out of the roof. It seals holes and things. So although nails would have to be removed and screws put in, the sealing part would be really easy. You just do it with these big brushes. You know, like a driveway seal kind of thing. And I thought, for the price, $60 or 5 gallons was pretty damn good. Mm-hmm. And it has an aluminum look then, but it doesn't matter what the look is. It's not, it seals in everything. So maybe four or 5 gallon pails or something would do that section, roughly.
Abby said actually there was a roofer out there yesterday, but she didn't say whether.
Yeah, so Ned is meeting on Saturday. Yesterday was Wednesday. He's meeting with Brian Roberts Roofing to get an estimate. So it sounds, I assume that means that the minor repair is not considered a major enough renovation that it has to go through all the hoops, fingers are crossed. So that's
great,
that's the news on that front. Mm-hmm. Any other? Mac and I are participating in a webinar that the Northeast Recycling Council is having next week on reuse events.
Oh, cool.
Athena Lee Bradley is a colleague and friend of Karen's and has been watching what we've been doing very closely and has replicated some of the things in other communities. She's done it. She did a toy exchange at a Indian reservation in New York. She's done, I don't know what else she's done. But anyway, she is able to put some research and publicity muscle behind the reuse thing and has been doing a great job doing that. So it's her webinar.
National?
It's open, I believe, to just anybody, and to anyone can participate. It's free, I believe.
It's advertised national, not to.
I believe so. It's the Northeast Recycling Council. Right. So it's probably just in the Northeast, although they get people coming from all over.
And when and where is it online? The webinar.
If you go to NERC, I think it's NERC.org,
okay.
Northeast Recycling Council. And I guess there was one other thing I wanted to say.
And what's what's the date again?
I don't remember the date of the. I've been so into this bag band stuff, guys. I need to remind me that we have.
We probably will be advertised on the NERC website.
It'll be on the website. Do you know the date offhand?
No.
Okay. I'll find it out.
Just on the recenter, what Matt mentioned, are we still going out after this? Is that the plan?
We had talked about that, so we had proposed that at some point, but it didn't get, I'm not sure it got wide circulation.
It didn't get wide circulation, and I have limited hours, and I've been focused on this bag ban and the toy exchange and getting some stuff going for that. So if you guys are available, I could probably swing it for a short amount of time, or we can pick a different day.
Who was talking about going out? Peter, Mac, Susan?
And what was the goal?
Well, we usually have a meeting every couple of weeks, and we were just going to have our meeting up there so that we could look at the space also.
And just let everybody take a look at the condition of the space and brainstorm ideas.
Could we meet there Tuesday?
Yeah, how about that?
As long as we're not, our webinar isn't Tuesday.
Tuesday.
Oh, wait a minute.
I'm looking
I do have a calendar. I think
Tuesday,
it is.
November.
I think it is Tuesday the 17th.
Yes. From 2 to 3:30 p.m.
Oh, well,
oh,
yeah.
There
okay.
you go. From 2 to 3:30. So we could meet out there Tuesday morning.
Okay.
Is that
the
good?
Access to the place.
Mm-hmm.
And you can register right here.
Mm-hmm. One last thing. I think the other task that we have to do over the winter, the subcommittee needs to do, is to just kind of do a review of how things went and
mm-hmm.
procedurally, and like take a look at our list of stuff that we accept and stuff we reject and modify that, because I think we did learn a lot over the course of the season about what is likely to go and what people just aren't interested in taking. So I think we need another a revision of that to reflect what we learned, basically.
And talk about the reopening and how we're going to launch that.
Yeah.
Event, promotion, whatever it's going to be.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Well, and I guess maybe it was Susan I talked to about and trying to come up with a way to measure what we've done this year.
Mm-hmm.
And that you and Diana were going to work on that or something. Or
Maria.
Oh,
well,
Maria.
Diana offered to help type stuff in, and Maria is offered to participate as well.
Yeah.
I don't know, did Maria say what her background was at the Tuesday meeting when you guys spoke with her about?
No,
she
has database background.
Yeah, that's all I know. So that's really exciting to have that kind of add that skill to our toolbox.
So you're doing this at a meeting, you're going to have your review?
At a subcommittee meeting?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think that would be.
Well, we're going to have, we have a list going of things that we want to accomplish over the next few months, and we'll start hammering out that list.
Mm-hmm.
There's a way any of us can throw you ideas.
No.
If we can't go to the meetings.
Only if you give us massages when you
That's
only
the
if it doesn't require more work.
Okay, anything else about the recenter?
I've got a couple of people coming out next Wednesday from organizations that want to come and get some stuff.
Great, great.
And anything that we cast out into the trash in particular, we really need to capture somehow. So we need to write it down or take a picture of it or something like that. So as stuff purge, as we purge, it's one thing if it goes to a...
Just keep a record of what doesn't move?
Right,
mm-hmm.
Right.
Yeah.
Well, not just that, but what we're having to throw away. So if it gets recycled, that's one thing. If it goes to equal building bargains or a secondary user, that's another thing.
Mm-hmm.
But if it goes into the dumpster, we really want to capture that.
Right, okay.
Yeah. Speaking of which, has the Who Takes What list gotten up on the city site?
No, it has not.
Will it?
Yes.
I'm not talking to you about, I mean, I...
It's not an easy task.
Yeah.
It's.
But all of us could have it without it being posted.
Definitely.
I would love to have that list.
Okay. I thought I sent you the Excel.
Oh, okay.
Who takes it's
sure.
an Excel spreadsheet. Didn't I send it to you guys?
I don't think so.
Susan, would you resend it?
Okay. The November 7th rally was a huge success. John Soss coordinated it. We had plenty of volunteers. We certainly had plenty of cars come through. I feel like the pumpkins were a game changer. Susan, that was a great last second idea that hopefully will be annual. But I think that a lot of people brought pumpkins. And those people might not have mm-hmm. come to the event, and I think they brought other things.
Well, and it helped with publicity. It mm-hmm. got the press more enthusiastic, and it really mm-hmm. did kind of help. And that was only possible because of the work that Diana and Jonathan had started trying to get more local composting done, and Smith Volk is now much more open to that. So it's all, you know.
So was it their truck?
Their trucks.
And did it
yeah.
get filled?
There were four loads taken. Not, they weren't heaping. They were. There were four
three,
or more.
Three and a half full.
Yeah.
Wow.
It was quite
excellent.
Good. And I got some really great pictures too.
Of the pumpkins?
Yeah, yeah.
That'd be great.
Yeah. So John, John sent me a note with some other things. So we had about 1.5 roll-offs of styrofoam. Almost 2 of bulky rigid plastic.
Not to mention, I mean, there was a lot of stuff taken. Again,
right.
There were families hanging out,
mm-hmm.
waiting for things to take. It was really, mm-hmm. it was one of the better rigid plastic recycling or reuse events that we've had.
Excellent.
Yeah, it was
great. In good weather, too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So three or four truckloads of pumpkins, mm-hmm. 27 bikes were collected. The Bikes Not Bombs people said that it's worthwhile if they get 25.
Oh.
And
mm-hmm.
so they made 27. He said that the original event that they participated in, they collected like 60 or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
And that was when we had a citywide postcard that went out to everybody. So I explained to him about that and that grant funding is gone. So he said that he'd be happy to come to all future rallies, and he was excited to also pick up some bulky rigid plastic pails that they do they
right.
ship parts and stuff in mm-hmm. when they send them to people, because then they're reusable
in
the countries that they send them to. So
there was a lot of shredding too.
There was a lot of shredding. The fellow that was here said that it was kind of slowish, mm-hmm. but I think it kind of depends on which driver you have, because some of the drivers go to really big, super, super popular
mm-hmm.
events, and then others, and some of them are going to be, for instance, Pro Shred, and I know the other place, Valley Green Shredding, they do work, their clients, their paid clients are banks, so they often go to a bank and will sit there for a number of hours to collect stuff from the bank's people. And those events are just really, really slow. So compared to that event, that type of event, we were great compared to an event in Westfield that they just had that was probably the only thing they did and was heavily publicized. It was slow. So I think we kind of have to look at it in perspective. He said that the one thing, Peter brought the recenter stuff that was great to start off with, mm-hmm. and that went really well. And John said we had plenty of volunteers, and he sent a thank you to the high school principal and to the high school, and he copied the mayor and Ned, because we had a lot of great high school volunteers.
We did. They were very good. Mm-hmm. They were really
enthusiastic.
Engaged.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay. Anything else about the November 7th rally? We had wondered whether or not a fall rigid plastics rally was worthwhile because a year ago the attendance was way down. Mm-hmm. We didn't get that much stuff. So this was really encouraging.
And people kept asking, are you guys doing it this year? Can mm-hmm. I bring, you know, so people, it's
there's an awareness.
There's an awareness.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay.
Can I interject just for a moment? Yep. I don't know if everyone has met Maria, so I wanted to stop and have Maria introduce herself. And
thank you. This is Maria.
Maria.
Last night, I hope Maria's for duty. I hope to be helpful in a number of different ways, whatever ways you need me, but, you know, it's starting.
We discussed that you had competency in databases. Is that correct?
Well, kind of. I have done some, and I've been, in the last couple of days, looking over all the out.
Oh, good.
Take
yeah.
forms of, and trying to just get my head around how we're tracking things and how we can streamline that more in the future. Trying to get a sense of, do we want to figure out poundage and how do we do that? And I think it's a good time to look into that, and I might be the right person to help with that.
Excellent. So can everyone just go around and tell your name in case Maria hasn't met you before?
Thank you.
David Shearer.
And David is on the Public Works Commission.
Okay.
Alan Calhoun.
Roger Green.
Diana Riddle.
David Starr.
Debbie Slavitt.
Roy Schmidt.
Ro is also on the Public Works Commission.
Okay.
Mac Everett.
Susan Waite.
Peter Rappelos.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you.
Peter, the Toy Exchange. That's why we're here today. What help do you need?
Can I interject just the Budinsky for a moment? Diana, thank you very, 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 very much, has already updated the flyers for the Toy Exchange. Debbie's going to be bringing some colored ones in that you guys can take and start posting. And Diana updated the one version in Spanish, etc. The timing was such that I asked Diana to do it over the weekend because Barbara Black had a big meeting on Tuesday that she wanted to be able to hand out the quarter sheets and the posters, etc. Mm-hmm. to, and she did. So,
great.
Thank you. To you.
I chatted with Donnie Rauscher. His auction zip number is ID number 337, if you go to auction zip. I had previously spoken with Paul Mueller-Reed, and he was too busy when it came down to it. Donnie is quite willing to do, I thought it might be a half hour auction or something, taking what we got from the raffle separation last year. I was hoping we could do an early shout out, maybe with this revised poster or something that we've got, so that we could get some proper donations in of stuff that we, you know, that were auctionable.
Mm-hmm. So, Peter, I have to say that at the end of the last meeting, I thought the auction idea was off the table because of the timing, and your guy had backed out. So,
well, I
so it's
mentioned
it's
we're still going to try this guy. So the other thing was, if we wanted to do, instead of a raffle, you know, a silent auction, I think, and I, Ro, I'm going to address this to you because I think it's important to establish our ability to raise funds for ourselves. Although we've got an account now, et cetera, I think being able, if we wanted a wood chipper or something down, that we wouldn't have to go through all the city stuff to get it. You know, we could start establishing that the reuse committee can, we've got a $10,000 allowance or something. So
no, it's not really an allowance. But
well, whatever it is. I like the idea
right.
very much of being able to raise funds for ourselves.
I think it's a great idea. I have to say that I am very concerned because it's a month away and that that it's a Herculean task to get the word out about anything in a month.
Mm-hmm.
And this would require not only organization from our on our part, but a huge publicity campaign and everything to try to get the toys donated.
Mm-hmm.
So I personally have grave reservations about making something like this happen this
mm-hmm.
late in the game. I just need to put that out there.
Well, no, I'm here to hear from folks.
Could we do
yeah.
a silent auction is a little less difficult
mm-hmm.
if we wanted to do that.
It's basically, we'd have the separation would be, the stage would be where the auction was separate from the exchange. I thought originally at 11 an auction, then maybe it's too long. Maybe at 10 is where we switch, or 10:15 or something like that, where we'd switch to. But I think it's good if we can raise some funds for ourselves, and this sort of would establish our ability to do that.
Mac, just to take a step back, are we all on the same page about raising funds? We had an email conversation
right.
about this at one point, and there were sort of two.
Well, we had a meeting about it actually about 3 meetings ago. We talked about it here.
Okay.
And I thought that we were having a wait and see.
I believe
protocol.
That was the. I don't think I have those.
Well, I will go on record as saying I was the one of the people who was a little concerned about the process because I was unaware that it was feasible to have a separate account, which apparently it is. And I think as long as the donors were aware that these items might be auctioned or sold, I was comfortable with that. And apparently
mm-hmm.
you had been doing that. So I'm okay.
Mm-hmm.
Process.
I believe that if I recall correctly, we said that we wanted to do a review of what kind of financial situation we were in and to figure out, to talk about this, to make sure that people had come to, that everyone was in accordance with how we were going to make funds and what they were going to be used for and what they can be used for and all that kind of stuff. So it doesn't mean that we couldn't do a silent auction, but it was on the table that over the winter we were going to figure this out.
Okay. Roger.
I can't find it.
My concern about having an auction where people bid on things is that you know we're trying to make this, it's a great place for people who don't have money to get toys.
Mm-hmm.
And if the best stuff is put aside for people who have the money to put it in an auction, it kind of removes them from that idea.
There's so much good stuff, though. There's so much good stuff, too.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I didn't think that it's really more like antique stuff, or I don't know. I mean, I know what you're saying, but there's so much good stuff that comes in.
Maria?
Do the items in the silent auction need to be toys, or can they be other things so that it's not competing with the toy exchange, because I really feel sensitivity towards, you know, the folks who are coming because they need the
right.
toys, and it's nice that they're getting good things, but they won't feel like they have to open their wallets for anything. I have never been to one of the events, but that's the sense that I get, and what a relief for a young mother or father to come and be able to do that and not feel like, oh, if I had the money for the auction, I could do this. But what if they were different things, like super nice items that were they could maybe want for themselves?
I guess I feel the same way today as I did 3 months ago when we talked about it, is this needs to be on the agenda as a topic, this fundraising idea.
Mm-hmm.
And with December 12th coming up, and this is our last meeting before that, it just feels like we haven't really had that discussion in full and come up with a resolution.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm not sure we're ready to raise funds. I think it's a great idea because we don't know what kind of support we're going to have from the city ongoing. We don't want to be in a place where 3 years from now, oh, the fund's gone, and we have to figure out a way to run some event. So I think building some sort of endowment in a sense is a nice idea. I'm just not sure that this December 12th is the time to start it.
Well, in the meantime, there will be things that are donated that have antique value or collector value and that kind of thing. They are, I would say, a relatively, you know, a fraction, a very small fraction of the huge quantity of stuff that comes in for the toy exchange. So, I mean, personally, I feel okay about, you know, if something clearly has, and it's easy enough to find out if it has antique value with Peter's advice or smartphone research or whatever. Personally, I feel okay about putting some of that stuff aside, and at least until we make a decision, and then if we decide we don't want to do it, we can deal with it later.
Yeah, I think that's a good way to deal with it, Roger. Then Diana.
Could we ramp up our request for donations? Imaging, you know, just make sure, you know, because we have a jar by the door, you know. Thank you for your support, you know. Okay.
Well, what yeah. that, that
you
also...
cash contribution?
Financial.
Sure.
Business.
Yeah, we made $200-something dollars last
yeah.
year, which
yeah.
is pretty phenomenal.
Yeah. 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 And do we have, this is a little bit off, but do we have an end user for this event now?
For what's left
yeah.
over, you mean, because
yeah.
of Salvation?
Yeah.
No, I haven't got that far yet, but...
Because if we don't, then we need to pay to throw the stuff away that
yeah.
that nobody takes, and then
that's
we would
huge.
Need to collect some money for that. We might need to say... there's an admission of a dollar or two to cover our costs of disposing of things that nobody takes.
I don't think that'll be the final disposal. I think so.
Who was the end user last year?
Salvation
Army.
Army.
Yeah. And I think
they said
they do toys in all my stores.
they
may
down
just have had
it. They said they didn't. Whatever. We have
I think
to figure that out.
Clearly we need to figure that out. So,
yeah,
Matt, could you explain, as somebody who's done the toy exchange for a couple of years, could you explain what needs to happen between now and December 12th from your standpoint as a lead volunteer?
Now you're really taxing my memory. I'm sure I have it written down somewhere, but I don't know if I could. I could. Well, there's certainly this. Are the space arrangements all set with Smith Boak? And then, you know, we definitely need to mobilize a crew of volunteers, because there's a big intake process and sorting process to set the space up.
And so you need volunteers in both Friday and Saturday?
Yeah, we need
yeah.
Friday night volunteers.
Especially Friday night, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Saturday the volunteers.
Yeah.
One thing we found last year, or the last couple of years, is we had the event scheduled from 9 to 12, I think, and basically by 10:30,
yeah.
it was just about done, and definitely by 11 it was over.
Yeah.
So I would keep that. I mean, that's been consistent for several years.
Mm-hmm.
It's a real early
but
event.
But it's advertised until
yeah.
noon, and there were people
it,
who came
yeah.
and
it's already,
were angry.
Okay, so it's already,
shut down
already put
or
out. Okay,
yeah.
so that's
yep.
that's done.
And it wasn't the end of the world. I mean, we
no.
just let some of the volunteers go and started packing things
right.
up.
Can I ask a question?
But
yeah.
We shouldn't pack up.
Who here is planning on volunteering either Friday or Saturday?
Friday.
Do we have a list on this?
I'm taking the list.
You're doing it?
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, just
right.
Just right.
Excellent. So, everybody.
But I can, I mean, you need to know Friday or Saturday or whatever. Or you need to know Friday or Saturday.
Yeah, well, I'll email everyone and get. Yeah.
Okay, got it. Thank you.
Okay, I said I would get back to Roche, so shall I just tell him not this year?
Can we just talk for a second about what we've done in the past?
Mm-hmm.
Because
sure.
in the past we have set aside things for a raffle, but it's been free.
Right.
So I'm not sure if we want to change that or not. And I think it is, we do need a bigger discussion about
mm-hmm.
the fundraising and how we interact with the public with this fundraiser, particularly around the toy exchange, because it's really popular and we've done it a number of times. And I think switching it up and making it a fundraiser is something we should think about.
Mm-hmm.
There were 26 items in the raffle last year.
Mm. Okay. So do we want to do that again this year is something we sort of need to decide now because it's coming up, and do we set those things aside for a fundraiser later, or do we do a free raffle?
Something that won't have an effect on the raffle, whatever we do, is that Family Fun is no longer here.
Mm-hmm.
So a lot of, not a lot, but probably 5 items in the raffle were from, were donated from Family Fun Magazine. They were brand new. They were dolls and stuff like that that mm-hmm. were high-end items that they used to get in as freebies because they wanted to be reviewed in their magazine. Mm-hmm. It's moved to New York City. It's no longer in Northampton. So that's mm-hmm. gone.
Are we all set?
Oh, Roger, yeah.
Oh, are we all set for traffic, you know, bringing traffic to the right place? We got all the signage all set up for that so that people know where to go when they bring their stuff, drop their stuff off. That's all.
Okay, so let's bring it back to the steps that need to happen.
Yeah, I mean, we essentially know the steps. We don't have to, I wanted Mac to, if he could, explain everything that needs to happen in the next 4 weeks, because it's a lot, and to add another piece to that is...
You mean in terms of the auction?
In terms of a potential...
I need the times that we're going to need volunteers so that I can send out an email and
okay.
get commitments.
Peter
people have
has not
volunteered.
Been available to meet with me yet, so after Peter and I meet, we will be in touch with you.
Okay.
And I have a notebook of stuff that we talked about last year and tasks and stuff, and I can share that with you and Peter.
Great.
Just one logistical note. The biggest problem we saw last year was people with their exchange stuff in hand trying to preview things for the raffle. So I see definitely having the raffle separate, and or whatever we do, separate and apart on the stage, using the side entrances so that people don't have all their packages and stuff in hand, which is, I thought that was just terrible last year. And then they can go and preview the raffle separately, so that would be the biggest logistical change. Everybody know what I mean? There's two entrances from the outside to the stage area, and that would be where that was set aside. People first go to their cars, take their things that they grabbed from the exchange, and then look at the raffle stuff, so it's not...
Maria, you had something?
I just wondered if for people who get there later in they might be disappointed or upset because there's nothing left. Is it possible to set some of the really good items aside and then replenish? I don't know if you do that, but maybe replenish
idea.
At 10 and then replenish at 11, because those are really good items. They're going to go anyway, or if they're brand new and they're in packages.
I think that's a really
you know.
Good idea. I mean, I don't know what we're doing with the divisions of the raffle versus what's out on the floor.
Right.
And so we
well,
need to clarify that with something that comes up every year. It's
right.
like, how do we decide what is a raffle thing? And
and
if it's going to be an auction thing, do we just set it aside for, sorry, later, like not even have it at this event? Mm-hmm. Do we want to have a raffle at this event or not? And is it, if I don't see how much more effort it is to have a live auction than it is to have this free raffle that we've done.
Right, I believe the raffle was created because in an effort to prevent people from fighting over things, or you know, I mean, if you get somebody who is a toy collector and they know that something is worth $150, $200, and somebody else wants it for their son Joey, how do you resolve that? And so the raffle items were items that we perceive to be either because we know toys and we have young kids, or because we know it's a collectible item that we perceive might be in demand.
So I think we need to have a vote or do
okay,
some
I,
kind
I,
of decision right
Roger
here.
Roger and I will do that.
I think I like the idea of recharging it at certain times, but it's going to make sorting the night before
mm-hmm.
much more complicated.
And we need a storage place.
You need a storage
mm-hmm.
place. You need to figure out what you're going to put aside. I like the idea if you know, and
yeah.
where it's going to be,
the
and
storage,
can I look at that
so
stuff? What's that stuff doing up
there?
Storage
is going to be a problem, especially
mm-hmm.
if we're not going to have if it's going to be up on the stage, we won't have the stage for storage,
right.
And potentially the Winter Farmers Market will be going on
mm-hmm.
in the hallway outside, so we're not going to have any storage.
But
I could bring a van for storage if you could store it outside in my van.
The nice thing about it is that it spreads it out,
mm-hmm.
and then when people come and the great stuff is not quite there yet, they're going to have to take other stuff and they won't mm-hmm. know. so we might get rid of more stuff.
Mm-hmm. That's a good point. Okay, so let's have a 5-minute discussion on whether or not we should have any sort of fundraising auction at the December 12th event. Do we have anything further to say?
I think there's sort of, you know, when we talk about the fundraising versus the free auction, there's sort of two levels of stuff here. There's stuff that, you know, that sort of truly has antique value that, you know, the collectors are after. And then there's stuff that's just like a really nice toy that's like a big Lego set or something like that. That's not like an antique, and a lot of families would like to have that for kids to actually play with. So I see a kind of two different kind of pockets there of and you know, clearly the kid, antiques and collectibles requires a little bit of thought and research and whatnot, but some of the other stuff is very obvious. Or someone brings in like a really nice dollhouse, for example. It's not necessarily an antique, but it would cost you a bunch of money to buy it. That's something that could go to a family with children, I think, you know, as opposed to a collector or a reseller.
So is that an argument for having a fundraiser or a silent auction? I'm not sure what you're getting at.
Well, I guess I feel like we could go ahead and make, I think we can make those decisions in the screening process. I don't think it's that difficult to do. And we take the stuff that we want to put into a free raffle and put it on the stage like we did last year. And then the other stuff, we just find some other spot that we can, and it's not going to be a lot of stuff, you know, and we stick it somewhere else and then put it aside.
So you're saying that the high-end toys we should put on the stage for a free raffle, and then the antique stuff we should just keep for a little while until we decide what we're going to do with fundraising. So not to have a fundraiser at the December 12th event. Okay. Diana likes that idea. Maria, you're nodding your head. Anybody else? Bro?
I have strong feelings.
Okay. Alan?
You have strong feelings.
Roger?
I think it's a good idea, you know.
What is it?
Just keep a hold of the good stuff. And
So not have a fundraiser on December 12th.
Right.
Make a plan for whether or not that's going to be a part of our future.
Yes.
Okay.
And I guess the other part of that is when that antique-y stuff comes in, saying to people who are donating it, are you okay with us using this as a fundraiser to support our activities?
Right.
And if they say no, then they can go out with the other stuff.
We could put a poster, saying if, you know, some of this material might be set aside for reuse event fundraising purposes. If you're not comfortable with that, say something.
Peter, this is your event. Are you comfortable with it progressing this way? So sounds like we're going to go ahead with the same raffle that we've had in the past with the higher end items, but if there are some really valuable items, we're going to put them aside for possible future fundraising. Maria?
I have a quick comment about what Susan just said about putting a sign up. That sign could lead to a lot of conversation with almost everybody who is donating a toy, and it could be a toy that has no resale value. So I think if it's only a very few amount of items that fall into this antique kind of high resale value, I would suggest not posting a sign, but just on one basis when that comes up, because otherwise you're calling attention to something that affects very few donations.
True.
And then you open up a huge can of worms that...
But it might bring up discussion among people. Like, it might make people
think about giving, but
it might be a good thing to have people bring in things that they would donate for a fundraiser in the future.
We can certainly add it to the handouts and stuff that we give. We give everybody who donates something a handout about how it works, and, you know, we could certainly add it into that. That would be easy.
I just think it's important to highlight that part. That's what I thought before, that some of this might be used should be very, very clear, kind of at the top in a box or something like that. So nobody can say, oh, well, where's my item that I donate, you know, later when they come the next morning or something.
But if it's only the antique items that we're doing that with, or, I mean, if we can be as specific as as possible. I think that would be more helpful than not in terms of what questions.
Okay, so that's decided. Just quickly, I think, Peter, would it be helpful if we had our next meeting a couple of days before the toy exchange?
That's fine by me.
Okay, so why don't we just set the next date as December 10th?
Yeah.
Peter, what else do you need from us for the toy exchange?
Publicity.
Okay.
We had 100 people in line to start last year, which was more than I've ever seen before.
Mm.
Yeah,
oh,
in line outside for the 8 o'clock opening. I think we should end earlier. That's important.
We can't end earlier because the posters are already.
It's already done.
It's already noon. We can talk about that for next year.
Mm-hmm.
Your posters, everybody. If you can start posting them around,
that's great. I'm posting for Habitat tomorrow, so I can do both.
If you, I will send you the JPEG. That Diana produced, and you can post that on your websites or deserves or put it in your email.
I actually can't post attachments on listservs.
Oh,
uh-huh.
No.
No. So I always have to just type out something for it, but mm-hmm. Just so you know.
Do you have more of these?
Okay, anything else about the toy exchange? Once again, we're going to have to postpone the Discuss America Recycles Day.
Well, it's on Sunday, so we postponed it out of
existence.
Out of existence. My personal feeling is that focusing on National Reuse Day, which isn't a national day yet, but we're trying to make it one, next year would be a really great thing.
Mm-hmm.
National Recycling Day. Around here, we have a lot of people who already know about recycling, and there's a lot of big money that's pushing recycling. The whole plastics industry, bottling industry, they're all pushing recycling. So I don't feel like it's as critical for us to make an event on
sure.
Recycling Day, but
mm-hmm.
It's good. It'd be good if we had mm-hmm. a lot of resources and time, but we don't.
What's the date again?
November 15th.
Okay.
Nice.
Anything else?
Thank you, everybody.
Move to adjourn. All right. Thank you.